Dear viewers, welcome to the YouTube channel H2O Chemistry. In this video, we are going to understand the physical and chemical properties of copper. So, we will see the physical property of copper first. It is a reddish brown metal. You could see the copper metal. You might have seen in the electrical wires. It is a reddish brown metal. It has a high density. When you compare it with the other metals like magnesium, aluminium, titanium, steel, iron, which has a high density, because when you calculate the grams per centimeter cube or cubic centimeter, let us have a cube like this. If you accommodate copper into this, the grams which occupy is 8.96 grams which occupies in the small volume, whereas in the same volume the aluminium will occupy only 2.7 grams. Hence, when compared to aluminium, copper is heavier and denser. That's the reason the combination of more and heavier atoms makes copper more dense than aluminium. There are less number of atoms in aluminium, there are more number of atoms in the copper. So it is high dense and have a high luxure. Luxure means brightness. When exposed to light, it is very, very bright, shiny it is. It is a good conductor of heat and electricity. That's the reason we use in our domestic electrical cables, electrical wires. Its melting point is 1356 Kelvin and its boiling point is 2835 Kelvin. If you talk about in centigrade, 1083 centigrade is a melting point, boiling point is 2567. So these are the physical properties of copper we usually come across. The next is chemical property. This chemical property we might have seen in our daily life, because if you have a copper vessel at your home, you might have seen when you keep it for a longer time, the surface of the copper vessel will change into green in color. This is actually called basic copper carbonate. The green color is actually formed because of the copper carbonate along with copper hydroxide. So this is the reason it changes its color. You will see the reaction. When the copper is exposed to oxygen, carbon dioxide and moisture in the atmosphere, which is collectively called as moist air, the copper reacts with these substances and forms a mixture of copper hydroxide and copper carbonate. The copper carbonate color is green in color, that's the reason it looks like green. It's a kind of corrosion. The copper is corroded into basic copper carbonate, which is a mixture of copper carbonate and copper hydroxide. Why do we call it as a basic? The copper hydroxide, which is it contains OH, the substance which has the hydroxide ions as a basic property. So this substance also has a basic property. That's the reason it is called basic copper carbonate. It is usually found in the surface. It is basic in nature, which is a type of corrosion happened in the copper metal. It may be asked in 1 marks. When copper gets corroded, the layer formed in the surface is thus basic copper carbonate. That's what your answer should be. Okay, let us see the next property, action of heat. When the copper is heated at two different temperatures, we get two different products. When the copper is heated below 1370 Kelvin, we get a black color substance, which is nothing but copper 2 oxide, CuO, which is black in color. Whereas, if you heat this black color substance above 1370 degree Kelvin, it will form a red color substance we call copper 1 oxide. The black color substance again changes into red color substance. We'll see what is the equation. When copper combines with oxygen below 1370 Kelvin, it forms CuO, copper 2 oxide, CuO, black in color. Whereas when the copper heated above 1370 Kelvin in the presence of oxygen, we get a red substance called copper monoxide, Cu2. This is how we have to understand this process. So at two different temperatures, copper reacts with oxygen to form two different oxides. Let us see the next equation, chemical property. Action of dilute acids. See, in the absence of air, you could see here, in the absence of air, the copper does not react with any dilute acids. You could see here, magnesium ribbon, zinc, aluminium, all are giving bubbles. That nothing but metal plus acid will give you salt plus hydrogen. In the reactivity series, copper is below the hydrogen. So normally in the absence of air, the copper does not react with dilute acids. Whereas in the presence of air, copper dissolves in the hydrochloric acid and the sulfuric acid to form the respective salt and water. The copper in the presence of air treated with the hydrochloric acid, the copper dissolves in the hydrochloric acid to form a green color copper chloride and water. Copper dissolves in the hydrochloric acid in the presence of oxygen to form a green color copper chloride and water. Similarly, when the copper reacts with dilute nitric acid, HNO3, it liberates nitric oxide gas, NO gas, along with the salt, copper nitrate and water. So this is how the reaction proceeds when the dilute nitric acid is treated with copper. Let us see the next chemical property, action of concentrated acids. Copper reacts with sulfuric acid. If you see the copper and sulfuric acid, it seems nothing happens in the test tube. But when you slowly heat this mixture, what happens? The copper reacts with the sulfuric acid to form copper sulfate and water, which releases sulfur dioxide gas. If you test with the acidified potassium dichromate paper, the filter paper dipped in the solution of acidified potassium dichromate, which is yellow in color, the sulfur dioxide gas will change the yellow color into green color. You could see the yellow color will turn into green in color. This indication that it liberates sulfur dioxide gas. So when the copper reacts with sulfuric acid, it produces copper sulfate, sulfur dioxide gas along with water. What about nitric acid? The copper reacts with nitric acid to produce copper nitrate, which is a green color substance, along with nitrogen dioxide gas, which is a reddish brown gas. This nitrogen dioxide gas along with water. So when the copper is treated with concentrated nitric acid, we get copper nitrate, a green color substance, along with nitrogen dioxide, reddish brown gas, which is a characteristic color of nitrogen dioxide, and along with water. So this is the product we get. Now, let us see the next chemical property, action of chlorine. So when you treat chlorine with the copper combines with the chlorine to form copper chloride. Cu plus Cl2 will give you CuCl2. You could see here, the chlorine gas is there inside. You could see the yellow light, yellow color. When you heat the copper and drop it into the vessel, the same vessel, what happens? The green color formation occurs, which is nothing but copper chloride, CuCl2. The green color formation occurs. Note, there is one exception. It may be asked in your one mark session. Copper is not attacked by alkali. What do you mean by alkali? The base which dissolves in the water is called alkali. The base is like sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide are soluble in the water, hence they call alkali. So these alkalis does not affect the copper. These are the very important chemical properties of copper. I hope this video will be very helpful in learning this physical and chemical property of copper. If you like this video, subscribe and click the bell button to get the notification instantly. Like, share it to your friends, comment if you have any doubt. Thanks for watching.